وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، وإن شرح هذا الكتاب نواقض الإسلام، إن شرح هذا الكتاب نواقض الإسلام written by شيخ الإسلام محمد ابن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. We finished the fifth naqid, and we're now going to move on to the sixth naqid, بإذن الله الكريم. The Shaykh said, من استهزأ بشيء من دين الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أو ثواب الله أو عقابه كفر، والدليل قوله تعالى ولئن سألتهم ليقولن إنما كنا نخوض ونلعب قل أبالله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون لا تعتذروا قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he goes into now istihza. And inshallah ta'ala, the way that we plan to go through this point inshallah ta'ala is by mentioning 7 points. 7 points inshallah ta'ala. The first of them is معنى الاستهزاء لغة واصطلاحا. What does استهزاء actually mean linguistically? And what does it mean شرعا? What does it mean according to the Sharia? What does the Sharia define as استهزاء? Ibn Faris, من أئمة اللغة, in his كتاب معجم مقاييس اللغة, he mentions that the word استهزاء, it means that إذا سخرة, is when the person mocks. And also the same is said by الراغب الأصفهاني, الأصفهاني in his كتاب المفردات. خليل ابن أحمد الفراهيدي in كتاب العين, he mentions that, he says الهزء, which is the أصل of the word, he says it means السخرية. It means to mock. And this is what the Arabs know as the word al-istihza. It's to mock. And the Aimatul Lugha, that's what they say. Ibn Faris, Mu'jam Maqayisul Lugha, Raghib al-Asbahani, he says that in his Kitab al-Mufradat, Khalil in his Kitab al-Ayn, and also Sahib al-Lisan al-Arab, Ibn Manzur. They all say the same. So that's what it means linguistically, in the language. In the Sharia, it means, as Al-Imam Al-Alusi mentions, rahimahullah, in his kitab, Ruhu Al-Ma'ani, Alusi, he mentions in the kitab, Ruhu Al-Ma'ani, which is a tafsir book. He says that the istihza is istighfaf, al-sukhriya, al-istihana, wa-tambih ala al-uyubi wa-al-naqais. It means to mock, it means to belittle, to put down. It means to bring out faults and mistakes and errors على وجه يضحك به منه, in a way that is laughed at. You bring out the faults and the mistakes in a jokey manner. وقد يكون ذلك بالمحاكاة في الفعل والقول والإشارة والإيماء. And he said that it can occur either by action or speech or either the gesture that a person does. All of that, it can fall under it, istihza. You can do istihza with your tongue, you can do istihza with your gesture, you can do istihza with your body, you can do it with your tongue and spit, say it. All of that. And then Alusi's definition is very comprehensive. Rahimahullah ta'ala. So we've defined what istihza means lughatan, and we've also defined it what it means shara'an, according to the sharia. We're now going to move on to the second point. The second point. Al-adilla ala kufri al-mustahza'u bihi. The evidences that show the person who mocks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the messenger, and the verses of Allah, that he becomes a disbeliever. The evidences is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ, if you ask them, لَيَقُولُنَّ, they will say to you, إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ, we were only enjoying ourselves and we were playing. قُلْ, say to them, Muhammad, أَبِاللَّهِ, in the verses of Allah, وَآيَاتِهِ, أَبِاللَّهِ, in Allah, وَآيَاتِهِ, and his verses, وَرَسُولِهِ, and his messenger, كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهَزِئُونَ, are you mocking? لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا, don't try to look for excuses for yourselves. قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ, you have become disbelievers, بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, after you were believers. Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 65 to Ayah 66. And the Shaykh rahimahullah brought that. Many scholars have extracted from this ayah that it's kufr akbar if a person mocks Allah or the Messenger or the Quran, that the person becomes a disbeliever. I'm going to now mention some of the scholars. Number one, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. He mentions it in his kitab al-Sarib al-Maslul ala Shatim al-Rasul. On this ayah, he says, وَهَذَا نَصٌ صَرِيحٌ فِي أَنَّ الْإِسْتِهْزَاءَ بِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُفْرٌ. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah says, وَهَذَا نَصٌ صَرِيحٌ. This is a clear-cut evidence that the person who mocks Allah, and he also mocks the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he also mocks the verse of Allah, that he's a disbeliever. This ayah is clear in this matter. He says this in his kitab, As-Sarib al-Maslul ala Shatim al-Rasul, ayah 33. Sorry, page 33. Page what? Page 33, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah. And he also says it in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 15th volume, page 48. And he also says it in page 49 as well. Both those pages, he mentions that it's what? This ayah is clear in this regard. Also from the scholars is Ibn Qudama in his kitab Al-Mughni, the 12th volume, page 298. He says, Man sabba Allah, anyone who insults Allah ta'ala kafar, he becomes a disbeliever. Man sabba Allah ta'ala, anyone who mocks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kafara, he becomes a disbeliever. Either كان مازحا أو جادا, whether he's joking or whether he's serious about this, when he insults Allah, whether he's joking or whether he actually means it, he's a disbeliever. وكذلك من استهزأ بالله, and the same is the person who mocks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أو بآياته, or his verses, أو برسوله, or his messenger, or his books. قال تعالى, and he brings the ayah, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ وَنَلْعَبُ قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Also, the third scholar is Ibn Hazm. في كتابه, his book, الفصل في الملل والأهواء والنحل. He mentions in the third volume, page 299, he says, صَحَّ بِالنَّصِ, صَحَّ بالنص, it has clearly come from the textual evidence, أن كل من استهزى بالله, that everybody who mocks Allah تبارك وتعالى, بعد بلوغ الحجة إليه, after the proof has reached him, فهو كافر, he is a disbeliever, he says. The fourth imam is Al-Allama Abd al-Rahman Nasir al-Sa'di rahimahullah. When he came to this ayah, he said, إِنَّ الْإِسْتِهْزَاءَ بِاللَّهِ, mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and mocking his messenger, he said, it's kufrun mukhrijun ala dini. It is disbelief and it takes a person out of the fold of Islam. لِأَنَّ أَصْلَ الدِّينِ مَبْنِيٌ عَلَىٰ تَعْظِيمِ اللَّهِ, Because the religion is built upon veneration of Allah, glorification of Allah. وَتَعْظِيمِ دِينِهِ And it's also built upon venerating and glorifying his religion. And also glorifying the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَالِاسْتِيزَاءُ بِالشَّيْءِ And when you mock something, it goes against that asal, he says. It opposes that particular foundation, which is to venerate and glorify Allah. And he opposes it, he says, أَشَدَّ الْمُنَاقَضَةِ And the way that it goes against it and it pushes it away, he said it's the greatest form. That istihza fully eradicates and fully gets rid of what? At-ta'zim. Glorification and honoring of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he mentions the ayat. And he says, أَنَّ مَنْ إِسْتَهْزَى بِشَيْءٍ And then he goes on to say, عبد الرحمن ناصر السعيديو, that anybody who mocks anything from the book of Allah, or the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, al-thabiti anhu, that is correctly transmitted from the Prophet. Or he belittles that and mocks it. Or he belittles it. Or he mocks the Prophet. فَإِنَّهُ كَافِرٌ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ He's a disbeliever of Allah تبارك وتعالى. The same was said by Al-Imam Fakhruddin al-Razi, he mentions it in his tafsir. He said the same thing that Abdul Rahman Nasir al-Sa'udi said. That istiza of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's religion. He said, إِنَّ الْإِسْتِئِزَاءَ بِالدِّينِ Mocking the religion. كَيْفَ كَانَ كُفْرٌ بِاللَّهِ He said, how can it become disbelief? He's putting that question forward. What is the reason why mocking the religion is kufr? He says, وَذَلِكَ لِأَنَّ The reason for that is because. And al-istiza'a yadulu ala istighfaf. He says that mocking indicates that the person is belittling the thing. It's putting it down. Wal-umdatul kubra, the greatest pillar in iman is what? Ta'zeemullah. It's to honor Allah, to venerate Allah, to glorify Allah. Bi-aqsa al-imkani, to the greatest of your, to the greatest is what iman stands on. To venerate Allah to the highest. And then he says, وَالْجَمْعُ بَيْنَهُمَا To bring them together. Which is بَيْنَ تَعْظِيمِ اللَّهِ Venerating Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى وَالْإِسْتِيزَاءُ بِهِ And mocking him is muhal, is impossible. So one will stay. When you mock, تَعْظِيمُ اللَّهِ will get out of the picture. And if تَعْظِيمُ اللَّهِ is there, then mocking can't come. Also Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab in Durr al-Saniyah, the 10th volume, page 121, he also, rahimahullah, he says something like that. Ibn al-Qasim, rahimahullah, also says it on the hashiyah of Ala Kitab al-Tawheed. Al-Shaykh ibn al-Uthaymeen, in the sharah of Kitab al-Tawheed, al-Qawl al-Mufid, he says the same. Al-Qadhi Iyad, rahimahullah, in his Kitab al-Shifa, he also says the same, rahimahullah ta'ala. So this is a mas'ala Ahlul Ilmi, they've consistently said, and inshallah ta'ala later, we're going to bring ijma'at, consensus in this particular issue. Al-Mas'ala al-Thalitha. We're now going to move on to the third, point, inshallah ta'ala, which is, La farqa, there's no difference. Fi kufri al-mustahzi'i. There's no difference, okay? There is no difference between the one that's mocking, okay? Whether he's joking or serious. There's no difference. If the person who's mocking is joking or he actually intended to mock, the scholars, بِلَا خِلَافٍ بَيْنَ الْعُلَمَاءِ There is no difference amongst the scholars that this person is a disbeliever. There's no difference of opinion. This is a consensus. Ahlul Ilm, they have a consent that whether you are mazihan, whether you are joking, أو قاصداً لحقيقة الاستهزاء, or you intend, or you what? You actually intend to mock and belittle, it doesn't matter to them. Both of them are kufr akbar. And as I said, بلا خلاف بين العلماء, there's no difference of opinion amongst the scholars, whatever madhab that they're from. قال ابن العربي المالكي رحمه الله ابن العربي the great Maliki scholar He says in his kitab, Ahkam al-Qur'an, when he came to the ayah of قُلْ أَبِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهَزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, he says, لَا يَقْلُ أَن يَكُونَ مَا قَالُوهُ فِي ذَلِكَ جِدًّا أَوْ هَزْلًا. He said, this statement of theirs doesn't go outside whether it being a joke or it being something they intended. It can't go outside of the two. لا يخلو, it doesn't go outside. It can't get out of. أن يكون ما قالوه في ذلك, when they said what they said, and we're going to know what they said, those people who said what they said, either they were joking or they were what? Serious. And then he goes on to say, وَهُوَ كَيْفَمَا كَانَ, whatever it may be, كَفَرَ, the person becomes a disbeliever. فَإِنَّ الْهَزْلَ بِالْكُفْرِ كُفْرٌ, he said, joking upon kufr is kufr. لَا خِلَافَ فِيهِ بَيْنَ الْأُمَّةِ, the ummah don't differ in this regard. فَإِنَّ التَّحْقِيقَ أَخُ الْحَقِّ وَالْعِلْمِ وَالْهَزْلُ أَخُ الْبَاطِلِ وَالْجَهْلِ. To intend something is the brother of what? Truth and knowledge. And al-hazl, joking, is the brother of falsehood and ignorance. So here what we take from it is this part where he says, فَإِنَّ الْهَزْلَ بِالْكُفْرِ, that when the person jokes with kufr, kafara, he becomes a disbeliever. لَا خِلَافَ فِيهِ بَيْنَ الْأُمَّةِ. And as we're going to see at the end of the book, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, when he brings all the nawaqid, he mentions that whether you're joking or you're serious, it doesn't matter. At the ending of the nawaqid, he mentions whether you mean it or not, this is kufr akbar. Also, the second scholar that brings the consensus in this issue is Al-Imam Al-Alusi rahimahullah. He said, إِسْتَدَلَّ بَعْضُهُمْ بِالْآيَةِ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْجِدَّ وَاللَّعِبِ فِي إِظْهَارِ كَلِمَةِ الْكُفْرِ سَوَاءَ وَلَا خِلَافَ بَيْنَ الْأَئِمَةِ فِي ذَلِكَ. He said that the scholars use this ayah to show that the person who is serious and the one who is joking in speaking statements of kufr and coming with statements of kufr or kufr manifesting from you, he said that it is the same to them. وَلَا خِلَافَ بَيْنَ الْأَئِمَةِ فِي ذَلِكَ. And there is no difference of opinion amongst the scholars in this regard. Scholars use this ayah to say, whether you're serious or joking, if kufr becomes apparent from you, that you become a kafir, whether you're joking or serious, it doesn't matter. And he says, وَلَا خِلَافَ بَيْنَ الْأَئِمَةِ فِي ذَلِكَ. And there is no difference of opinion amongst the ulama in this regard. Sheikh Sulaiman ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, the grandson of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and the first imam, okay, who actually explained Kitab al-Tawheed. Who explained what? Kitab al-Tawheed, the author of the Kitab, Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, fi sharhi Kitab al-Tawheed. He says, أَجْمَعَ الْعُلَمَاء, the scholars unanimously have agreement, عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَنِ اسْتَهْزَأَ بِاللَّهِ أَوْ بِكِتَابِهِ أَوْ بِرَسُولِهِ أَوْ بِدِينِهِ كَفَرْ وَلَوْ كَانَ هَازِلًا لَمْ يَقْصِدْ حَقِيقَةَ الْإِسْتِهْزَاءِ إِجْمَاعًا. He said that the scholars are unanimously in agreement that the individual who mocks Allah, who mocks the book of Allah, the messenger, the religion, kafara, he becomes a disbeliever. وَلَوْ كَانَ, even if he is, وَلَوْ كَانَ هَزِلًا, whether he's a joking person. And he didn't intend this mocking, and he didn't intend to belittle nothing. That's not what he intended. He's still a kafir. إِجْمَاعًا, by consensus. Ibn al-Qayyim also transmitted that إِجْمَاع رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. He what? He brought the ijma' in this issue, and he clarified that there's no difference between whether the person is serious or whether the person is joking in this matter. وَأَنَّهُمَا سَوَاءَ, that they're the same. That's what he mentions, rahimahullah. And what he says, Ibn al-Qayyim, because his kalam is very long, in his kitab, إعلام الموقعين, the third volume, page 76, is that he says, the exceptions here is the person who does a mistake. Okay, the مُخْطِي. And he brings the evidence for that. The one who says, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuk, akhta'a min shiddati al-farah. The one who said, when he lost all of his property in the desert, his food and everything that belonged to him was on his riding beast, he got it wrong. slip of a tongue came from him. And so he said, instead of saying, "Oh Allah, you are my Lord and I am your slave," he said to Allah, "You are my slave and I am your Lord." And then the hadith says, "Akhta'a," he did a mistake. For what reason? "Lakin akhta'a min shiddati al-farah." He did a mistake because of his excessive happiness and joy. So he did a mistake. He was very happy, that's why. And he says, an exception here is the mukrah, the one who has been forced to say these kind of statements. He said, there's an exception as well. It's an exception. And so he brings the ayat for that as well. إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ, except the one who's been burdened into it. And he also says, النَّاسِ, the one who's forgetfulness. If something like kufr occurs from him, then that person is also an exception. But he says, as for other than those things, joking and seriousness doesn't change the ruling of kufr. Whether you're joking or you're serious, it doesn't change. The ruling are both the same. So you can see it there, inshaAllah ta'ala, in the I'lam al-Muwaqqi'in by Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Al-Mas'alat al-Rabi'ah. The fourth mas'ala that we're going to go into is that the evidences to show that there is no difference between al-Mustahzi'u al-Qasid, the one who is mocking and he intends it, and the one who is joking. We brought the consensus, and that should be enough, to be honest. But there also, the ayah itself proves that there's no difference. The ayah itself that we brought at the beginning, and the ayah that the Shaykh himself used, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, indicates that there's no difference between the one who is joking and the one who is serious. Let's look at the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتُمْ, if you ask them, لَيَقُولُنَّ, they will say to you, إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ, We were only indulging into this. And the word nakhudu here means so we could use up our free time. That's why we were doing it. وَنَلْعَبُ, we were only playing. قُلْ, say to them, أَبِاللَّهِ, the verses are in Allah, sorry. وَآيَاتِ, and his verses. وَرَسُولِهِ, and his messenger. كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ, you were mocking. So from the ayah, what they were doing was what? They were what? They were joking. They weren't serious. The ayah from the Zahir, what it shows us is that they were not serious. They actually were joking. And Imam Al-Alusi, rahimahullah, mentions that. He says, وَأَرَادُوا إِنَّمَا نَلْعَبُ وَنَتَلَهَا. إِنَّمَا نَلْعَبُ, we are playing. And we're just enjoying ourselves. لِتَقْصِيرِ مَسَافَةِ السَّفَرِ, so we can shorten the long travel that awaits us. They just want it, It's called the banta, is that the journey is long. So when you laugh and you joke, the journey seems very short. You get to your destination quickly. That's what we wanted from it. وَذَلِكَ لِقَطْعِ الطَّرِيقِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ ذَلِكَ مِنَّا عَلَىٰ طَرِيقِ الْجَدِّ. So they're trying to say this was not from us, seriousness. We didn't actually mean it like when we said it. But then look what Allah said to them, قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِ وَرَسُولِي كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. And what shows that it doesn't matter whether you're serious or not is that their kufr came without them being asked whether they were serious or joking about it. No one asked them. The ayah did not say to them. The Prophet was already informed about it, that these individuals are disbelievers. So when they came, all that was waiting for them was لَا تَعْتَدِيُوا, don't look for excuses. What you guys have done is clear-cut kufr. You've come with kufr. Alusi mentions that, rahimahullah, and he extracts that. Also, Abil Hafs al-Hanbali, he mentions that in his kitab al-Lubab, fi ulum al-kitab. Also, Al-Kaya Al-Harrasi rahimahullah, he mentions in his Ahkam Al-Quran. Also Ibn Abi Hatim in his Tafsir, and Ibn Jarir Al-Tabari, they bring it from Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. He said, قَالَ رَجُلٌ فِي غَزْوَةِ تَبُوكِ فِي مَجْلِسٍ يَوْمَا. And he mentions the story of what happened, that a group of people sat in a gathering one day in the battle of Tabuk. And they were sitting and they said, مَا رَأَيْتُ مِثْلَ قُرَّائِنَا, I've not seen anyone like our qurra. They are what? They love to eat a lot, and they love to lie a lot, and they're the most cowardice when meeting the enemy. And then a man in the gathering said to them, "You are liar, وَلَكِنَّكَ مُنَافِقٌ, but you are a hypocrite." And I will tell the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam what you guys were saying. The matter then reached the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and then the ayah came down. Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, فَأَنَا رَأَيْتُهُ, I saw these individuals, مُتَعَلِّقًا بِحُقْبِ نَاقَةِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, they were holding the reins of the Prophet's riding beast, his horse. And he was saying to them, قُلَ بِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. The Prophet was saying that to them. And Imam Al-Allama Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i, he authenticated this in his kitab As-Sahih al-Musnad min Asbab al-Nuzul, that this story about this narration that Ibn Abi Hatim brings and Ibn Jalil al-Tabari bring, that is authentic. The word that he used, they used, مَا رَأَيْتُ مِثْلَ قُرَّائِنَا هَؤُلَاء, like, I haven't seen anyone like our qurra. The word qurra, they meant by the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and his companions. They were using it for the Prophet and his companions. And the word qurra, it actually means the scholars. When the word qari is used in the time of the Salaf, and now what it's used as is different. Now the qari is known by a person who just reads the Quran and he knows the different dialects of the Quran, and the mashallah, he reads the Quran. Like, according to the Salaf, the qurra are the ulama. They were known as the what? The scholars and the people of knowledge. That's why you find what Bukhari narrated in his Sahih from Hudhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which he said, يَا مَعْشَرَ الْقُرَّاءِ اسْتَقِيمُوا فَقَدْ سَبَقْتُمْ سَبْقًا بَعِيدًا فَإِنْ أَخَذْتُمْ يَمِينًا وَشِمَالًا لَقَدْ ضَلَلْتُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. He said, يَا مَعْشَرَ الْقُرَّاءِ, O Qurra. And when Hudhayfa said, O Qurra, he's not talking to the what? The reciters only. He's talking to the ulama. Because back at that time, the person wouldn't just study the Quran and have no fiqh, no aqidah. He wouldn't be like that. Now you find the person's a qari. If you ask him a sa'il pertaining to tahara or salah, if you ask him a sa'il pertaining to aqidah, very basic aqidah related issues, he may not even know it. And he's called qari. He's a qari. That's not how the Salaf would see the word qari. ولذلك ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه عنهما, he said, قدم عيينة ابن حسن, and he mentions in that story, وكان القراء أصحاب مجلس عمر, and from the قراء were those who would sit with عمر رضي الله عنه in his assembly. His, the قراء here means the ulama would be sitting with him. Hafiz ibn Hajar commented that on that on Fath al-Bari, on that statement of Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman that I mentioned, and then he said, al-qurra'u jam'u al-qari al-muradu bihim al-ulama'u bil-qur'ani wa-sunnati wa-sunnati al-ibad, that the qurra are the scholars of the Qur'an and the sunnah. So the qurra, when they said that our qurra, they eat a lot, and our qurra are cowardice, and our qurra, they met the Prophet and the companions. مسألة الخامسة, the fifth مسألة that we're going to go into, is الذين حكم الله, those who Allah تبارك وتعالى ruled onto them, their kufr, in this ayah that Allah ruled on them that they're kuffar because of their mockery, they were believers before this. They were believers before that. Before they became disbelievers, they were actually believers. على الصحيح من أقوال أهل العلم, according to the strongest opinion of the scholars. Because the ayah clearly says, قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ, كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, you have become disbelievers after your iman. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions that in his kitab al-iman, page 259, with the tahqiq of Shaykh Nasir rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh Nasir al-Din al-Albani. He mentions that, that these individuals were kuffar, and he uses that part of the ayah and he explains that قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ, you have become disbelievers بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, after your iman. Also, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, he mentions that in his Durar al-Saniyah, the 10th volume, page 125, that these individuals were believers and that they turned out to be disbelievers after the statement which they said. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, in his Sharh of Nawaqid al-Islam, when he commented on this verse, he said, قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ هَذَا دَلِيلٌ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. He says, this is an evidence that they were believers. وَلَمْ يَكُونُوا مُنَافِقِينَ. They weren't hypocrites. إِذْ لَوْ كَانُوا مُنَافِقِينَ لَمْ يَقُلْ. Because if they were hypocrites, it would not have been said, قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. لَأَنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَيْسُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. Because the munafiqeen are not, they are not mu'mins. مِنَ الْأَصْلِ, in terms of their asl, their default position. فَلَا يُسَمُّونَ مُؤْمِنِينَ. So they are not referred to as mu'mineen. وَإِنَّمَا يُسَمُّونَ بِالْمُنَافِقِينَ. Rather, what they will be called is hypocrites. وَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Allah said, فِي الْآيَةِ, in a verse في الْمُنَافِقِينَ, in regards to the hypocrites, look what Allah said about them. وَلَقَدْ قَالُوا كَلِمَةَ الْكُفْرِ. They said a statement of kufr. وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِمْ. And they became kuffar after the Islam. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan said, وَلَمْ يَقُلْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ. This ayah says, وَلَقَدْ قَالُوا كَلِمَةَ الْكُفْرِ وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِمْ. وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِمْ. And Allah didn't say, وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ. Why? لأن Islam here means, he says, إِعْلَانُ الدُّخُولِ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ. They showed to the people that they came into Islam. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ صَادِقًا فِي قَلْبِهِ. Even that they were not truthful about it in their hearts. Are we together? And he carries on speaking, rahimahullah ta'ala. So the ayah is talking about what? The ayah is talking about a group of people who were believers. They were what? Group of people who were what? And these group of people who were believers, they left the fold of Islam. بِمُجَرَّدِ هَذَا الْقَوْلِ. Just by that statement which they said. And of course those statements of the ulama all state, all prove that there is, that they were believers. المسألة السادسة, the sixth mas'ala, which is الاستهزاء ينقسم إلى قسمين. That the استهزاء is categorized into two. Okay? The استهزاء is categorized into two. The first one is الاستهزاء الصريح, the direct type of mockery. Okay? It's the direct type of mockery. And this type of istiza, this type of mockery, is the one that have occurred, the one that the ayah has shown. These individuals, what they said was direct, it was straight to the point. And it's the one that occurred from these individuals. And other statements that you find people say nowadays, which are clear cut, which are the same as this. There are ayats in the Quran, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions the story of these those who mock. For example, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. That the disbelievers, the dunya has been beautified for them. The kuffar, Allah beautified the dunya for them. They see the dunya to be the ultimate goal. وَيَسْخَرُونَ, and they mock. Who? مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the believers. The kuffar's mocking is direct. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in another ayah, الَّذِينَ يَلْمِزُونَ الْمُطَّوِّعِينَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ إِلَّا جُهُدَهُمْ فَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنْهُمْ سَخِرَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. In Surah At-Tawbah, ayah 79. This ayah, الَّذِينَ يَلْمِزُونَ الْمُطَّوِّعِينَ, ayah 79 that I mentioned in Surah At-Tawbah, it has a sabab al-nuzul that Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in hadith Abi Mas'ud al-Badri, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, qal. He said that when this ayah came down, the ayah to sadaqah, the verse of sadaqah, give sadaqah out. He said, a man would come, he would give as much as he has, the money he has, and the ability of what he has. A group of the kuffar who were looking at the believers, they saw the believers bringing what they have, the money, they bringing everything forward. فَقَالُوا, they said to them in a mockery way, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌّ عَنْ صَاعِ هَذَا. Allah is rich from your sa'. What does Allah need your money for? What does Allah need your this for? What do you guys think that you're doing? He started to mock them. And the ayah came down, الَّذِينَ يَلْمِزُونَ الْمُطَّوِّعِينَ فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ. Those who are slandering and they're putting down the مُطَوِّعِينَ, those who are giving out, the believing people who are pious and obeying Allah, who are giving from their sadaqat. And they're only bringing what they can. So they're mocking the ones who are bringing the small amount. It's like somebody brings you £5 for sadaqah. He says, are you serious? Are you serious? £5? Well, that's all he has. That's all he can bring to the table. That's what the ayah is referring to. The second type of istiza is al-istiza, which is غير صريح. It's not direct, it's indirect. Okay? And this, brothers, is بحر الذي لا ساحل له. This is an ocean that has no shore. The indirect ones. It's winking. When you wink, gestures, bringing out your tongue, doing all of this. These are a form of mockery. Might not be direct, but it's indirect. Putting your hand down, like dismissing something when it's being told to you. All of these are استهزاء. Allah mentioned the Quran, إن الذين أجرموا كانوا من الذين آمنوا يضحكون وإذا مروا بهم يتغامزون. يتغامزون من when? It meant what? We took it in مطففين. It would wink. Body gestures. Kind of movements. Somebody's telling you something. You nudge another person right next to you. These are all forms which are indirect. They are what? They are indirect. And we expanded on this ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَضْحَكُونَ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ. We expanded on that when we did the tafsir of Surah Al-Mutaffifin. But if you want to look more into this type, the second type, or the types in general about the istihza, if you want to look more into it, then look at the kitab سَبِيلُ النَّجَاتِ وَالْفِكَاكِ by Hamad ibn Atiq, which is part of the Majmu' al-Tawheed. And Muhammad Abdul Wahab's Risala on Hukm al-Murtad, which is present in his Durar al-Sariya, the 10th volume. The seventh and the final one that inshaAllah ta'ala we're going to speak about is some of the types of mockery that we see. Some mockeries that are taking place that we see. Shaykh ibn al-Uthaymeen mentions in his kitab al-Qawl al-Mufid, he says, man istahza bis-salah, the person who mocks the prayer, for instance. Or he mocks the voluntary acts, or zakat, or fasting, or hajj. He said, فَوَا كَافِرٌ بِإِجْمَعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. He's a kafir by consensus of the Muslims. Anybody who also mocks, he says, بِالْآيَاتِ الْكَوْنِيَّةِ. He mocks the universal signs. بِأَنْ قَالَ مَثَلًا. For example, he says, إِنَّ وُجُودَ الْحَرِّ. The heat being here, this excessive heat, in the days of winter, is dim-wittedness. Why would there be heat? He's mocking it. Why would there be the sun out when it's meant to be winter? That's so dumb. Statements like that. This is istihza that many mentioned. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen says that's present. Or the opposite. Saying, why is it cold when it's meant to be sunny, summer? I swear this is dumb. Huh? That's what some say. That's kufr mukhrij min al-millah. The person will leave the fold of Islam because of this. Because Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's actions are based upon wisdom. And you've just considered Allah's actions dim-wittedness. That's what he says. Also from the things is, as Abdul Rahman ibn Hassan ibn Muhammad Abdul Wahab mentions in his kitab, Qurrat Uyun al-Muwahideen, he mentions that a person can become a kafir because of a statement that they said. And an action a person does, they can become a kafir. وَأَشَدُّهَا, from the greatest of them, خَطَرًا, is إِرَادَاتِ الْقُلُوبِ, the things that come to the heart. He says, فَهِيَ كَالْبَحْرِ الَّذِي لَا سَحِيلَ لَهُ. This is like an ocean that has no shore. وَمِنْ هَذَا, and from this angle, is الْإِسْتِهْزَاءُ بِالْعِلْمِ وَأَهْلِهِ. Is when you mock the people of knowledge, the ulama. When you mock knowledge, ilm of the religion, you mock it. وَعَدَمُ احْتِرَامِهِمْ لِأَجْلِهِ. And you have no respect for the people who are carrying knowledge. You don't respect them. You mock them. You belittle them. But we have to expand on what we mean by mocking the scholars. The mocking of the scholars, it has tafsil. It's not like Allah and the Quran and the what? And the Sunnah and the whatnot. The istiza' of the ulama fihi tafsil. It requires what? It requires expanding on. فَإِنْ أَرَادَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئُ بِهِمْ If the person who is mocking intends by mocking the scholars, بِأَشْخَاصِهِمْ وَذَوَاتِهِمْ He's mocking them as individuals. Okay? For example, he's mocking them because of their character or the way they look. Okay? Maybe he's blind. So he's mocking the fact that he's blind. Etc. And he's not talking about in any way, form or shape the religion that they are upon and their piety. That's not what he's talking about. And their steadfastness. Then this is not kufr, but this is kabiratu min al-kabair. It's from the major sins. And it falls under the ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٍ مِّنْ قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّنْ نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُنَّ And as I said before, is the statement of Ibn Asakir, لُحُومُ الْعُلَمَاءِ مَسْمُومَةِ وَعَادَةُ اللَّهِ فِي هَتْكِ أَسْتَارِ مُلْتَقِصِّهِ مَعْلُومَةِ فَمَنْ أَطْلَقَ لِسَانَ بِالْعُلَمَاءِ بِالثَّلْبِ أَبْلَاهُ اللَّهُ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ بِمَوْتِ الْقَلْبِ That the scholars, their flesh is what? Is poisonous. If you open your mouth and your tongue towards the scholars and you speak about them and you slander the scholars and the people of knowledge, then what will happen to you is that your heart will die before real death comes to you. A lot of people will apostate from Al-Islam, they will leave the fold of Al-Islam, they will walk away from Al-Islam just because of the fact that they open their tongue towards the Ahlul Ilm, the people of knowledge. Ibn Asakir says, "Luhumul ulama'i masmuma." The flesh of the scholars is poisonous. And if you eat something that's poisonous, what will happen to you? You'll die. So you're going to kill yourself by opening your mouth towards the scholars. And Al-Allamah Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti, rahimahullah, in his tafsir of this ayah, يَا يَلَذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٍ مِّنْ قَوْمٍ عَسَاءٍ يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّنْ نِسَاءٍ عَسَاءٍ يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُنَّ Ayah 11, Surah Al-Hujurat. Al-Allama Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti, he expands on it. And he talks about that in more details. As for, if the mocking though, which is the second time, of the scholars and those who are steadfast, okay, not just the scholars, but those who are steadfast, you are mocking them because of the fact that they are pious. You're mocking them because of the good that they are holding onto, the religion that they are holding onto. For example, you mock their bid. Or you mock the what? You mock their shortness of their thobe. He said, look at their clothing, it's shrunk. Or you mock their bid. Okay? Or you mock them shortening their mustache. If the mockery in this issue is lima hum alayhim min ad-deen, is due to that, the religion that they are upon, then this is istiza of the sharia. It will fall under Istiza of the ayat of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, fall under that. And this is kufrun mukhrijun alil millati bila khilafi bayna al-ulama. This is what? It will take you out of the fold of Al-Islam. It will take you out of the fold of Al-Islam without no debate amongst the scholars. This statement that I mentioned right now and how I expanded on it, I took it from the kitab Rawdatul Talibin by Al-Imam Al-Nawawi rahimahullah. Al-Imam Al-Nawawi mentions that. That's the two types that we categorize what? That we categorize the ulama in. Also, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab in his kitab, Ad-Durr al-Saniyah fi al-Masail al-Najdiyah, you will find it there. Fatawa al-Lajna al-Da'imah, they also mention it. Hashiya of Abdul Rahman ibn al-Qasim on Kitab al-Tawheed, you will find it there. Sheikh ibn al-Uthaymeen, you will find it there, speaking about it. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, It is al-irshad ila sahih al-i'tiqad. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan mentions it there. Aqidat al-Tawheed. He also mentions it there. Rahimahullah. He mentions it there. In kitab that he wrote is Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan. He has a kitab called al-irshad ila sahih al-i'tiqad. And he also has another kitab called Aqidat al-Tawheed. Both of those books, Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan mentions it as well. So we've concluded here the sixth nullifier of the person's religion. Bifadlillahi ta'ala, we will conclude there inshallah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.